Ladies and gentlemen, both warriors have entered the ring, and this is the main event of the evening. Your judges at ringside, Andrew Campbell, Samantha Bulner, and Malcolm Bulner. Your doctor at ringside, Dr. Peter Lewis. Your timekeeper, Tom Davis. Your referee in charge of this heavyweight contest, Mr. Ignatius Missalides. The WBF president at center ring, Mr. Mick Croucher. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Melbourne Exhibition and Convention Centre and everybody watching live around the world on Epicenter TV, are you ready? It's main event time! 12 by 3 minute rounds, boxing rules in the heavyweight division, and they are fighting for the WBF World Heavyweight title. Firstly, fighting out of the red corner, trained out of Shaper Gym, tonight wearing black trunks with red and white writing. Official weight 113 kilograms even. A professional fight record of 86 fights, 74 wins, 3 draws, 40 fights ending by knockout. Coming out of the United States of America, give him an Australian welcome, ladies and gentlemen, James Lights Up Toney! And across the ring, his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, trained out of One More Round Gym. Tonight wearing black shorts with white piping. Official weight 116 kilograms even. A perfect fight record of 15 fights, 15 wins, 14 coming by knockout. Representing Perth, Western Australia, Australia, ladies and gentlemen, Lucas Big Daddy Can I please have both fighters to centering?
Okay, boys, as I discussed the rules here in the change room, I want you to play my commands at all times, protect yourselves at all times. Touch gloves now and good luck.
That referee Ignatius Missalides.
A 12-round fight to find our heavyweight world champion, ladies and gentlemen.
Here for the vacant WBF Heavyweight Championship of the World. Australia's great white hope, Lucas Big Daddy Browne in the blue corner with the black trunks and the red gloves. And of course, the five. Yep, absolutely. The five.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here. We are live. And it
James
all
lights out
starts
Toney in the black trunks
now.
The black
round number one.
Corner. Let's go for round number one. The height and reach advantage is very, very clear to see with Lucas Browne.
James lights out Toney, certainly carrying quite a bit of excess. Lucas Browne in brilliant condition here. James Toney, one of the greats, one of the all-time greats, defensive genius in the past, never been stopped.
Oh, absolutely. Barry, let's recap. 86 professional fights, 74 wins, 45 by way of shortcut, by knockout, I should say, I guess, and three draws, and he's only lost 7 times. And those losses, I think he lost to Montel Griffin twice, he lost to the great Roy Jones Jr., and he's only lost to some very, very good company.
Lost to John Ruiz after winning the world heavyweight title off him. He had it taken off him because he was...
Supposedly tested positive.
But James Toney looking very adept in this opening minute or so.
Dangerous looking fighter. Forget the size, forget the bulk, forget the height differential, the reach differential, but a dangerous fighter. One that is never over as Lucas Big Daddy Browne with certainly the height and reach.
And look, Lucas, a very, very dangerous man indeed. You know, big man, big puncher, but he's never been in the ring with a man of this calibre.
When you look at it, career rounds for James Toney, 646 and an amazing 333 in title fights. Title fights, he's had 36. That means he's had 21 more fights for titles than Lucas Brown's had in actual title fights.
Yeah.
And look, for 24 wins and 7 losses, but this...
James Toney has collected 12 world titles during his illustrious career. Phenomenal record.
An amazing record, Barry, when
amazing.
You consider it.
From middleweight to heavyweight. One of the only two men to stop the great Evander Holyfield.
Turned professional way back on October 26 in 1988 with a TKO win in Mount Clemens over Stephen Lee. He's fought in many parts of the United States as Lucas pushes him over. He's going to incur a warning. That's the second. That's the second time he's done that now, Lucas.
I think an accident more than anything.
A little bit off balance, James Toney, but nice left hand by Lucas Brown using that reach advantage that he has. 116.6 kilos, Lucas Brown. 113.6, James Toney. So a 3 kilo weight advantage to Lucas Brown, plus the height and reach. But let me tell you, folks, in the bigger scheme of things, that doesn't play a big part in tonight's fight.
No, James Toney in the past has been in the ring with some of the biggest and best heavyweights in the world, and always acquitted himself well. The likes of Samuel Peter, John Ruiz, of course, the great Evander Holyfield.
End of round number one.
Twice.
Absolutely.
He's been with the best. And
I actually thought Lucas won. I'll tell you why. Only because he threw that left hand a couple of times. There was nothing in it. I mean, he clearly never saw it in the round. I guess that's about it, Barry Mott. But that's it. It's how did you see it at home? And I hope you're enjoying our Epicenter TV live stream coming to you in your home, wherever in the world you may be. At the moment, it's 25 minutes to 7 here in Melbourne time. And, congratulations to our promoters. Congratulations to all the people behind the scenes, our cameramen, Paris, Nick, Steve, the boys, Alex from Paris Productions, and they've done a remarkable job here tonight. Congratulations to my fellow commentator here, Barry Michael, who's anchored me and made me look good here tonight. Otherwise, I'd be in real strife. But
You certainly know what you're doing in the commentary position, Brad.
And Lucas Brown tries to open up on James Toney, and James has a wry smile on his face and says, okay, well, that's the way you want to do it. But Big Daddy Brown, Australia's great white hope, can he take on and defeat James Toney? Lights out Toney, one of the most experienced fighters to come to this shore. And Barry, I said a little earlier on, the last big heavyweight clash that happened in this state was when the great Smokin' Joe Frazier came down to Australia and fought Jimmy Ellis, the main sparring partner of Muhammad Ali, way back in March 1975.
Yep.
And that was 38 years ago. 38 years and 2 months, if you like. And that was the last big heavyweight fight that took place in this. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that Lucas Brown and James Toney are of the caliber of Jimmy Ellis and of course, the great Smokin' Joe Frazier. But certainly James Toney is in that league when it comes to legendary status.
James Toney's certainly in that league. The great Joe Frazier went on after the Jimmy Ellis victory at the St Kilda football ground.
Junction Oval, the home of the mighty Lions.
To have the greatest, for my money, the greatest heavyweight fight in history, the thriller in Manila against the great man.
It was exactly 7 months after he left Australian shores. He went back to his home and then trained and got ready for that fight against Muhammad Ali at the Araneta Coliseum in the Philippines, from memory.
Yep, it was the most brutal heavyweight fight I think I ever saw.
Absolutely. I was there, you were there. I know Mick was there, and there's probably half the crowd here were there. I reckon I was about all of probably 20 years old. Oh, James Toney doesn't like something there. He just waves to Big Daddy Lucas Brown. He's all business, Lucas Brown.
James Toney seeing the shots well. Not throwing a lot back in return, but making Lucas Brown miss at the moment.
Enthralling contest taking place here. James Toney, Lucas Brown trying to use that feeder, that left lead that he's got. Has a big height and reach advantage over James Toney, but just accidental. No real intention there, of course, just size and bulk. And Lucas touches the gloves and says, sorry, mate.
James Toney's yet to really, really unleash. We tried a good left hook there. To Lucas's credit, evaded that well.
There's the little short left hook in the right hand that just missed the mark by James Toney. Lucas is trying to find a rhythm, trying to find a range, trying to find a home for that left hand followed by the straight right hand, but nothing there at this stage.
Fighting a smart fight at the moment, Lucas Browne.
Nice left lead by Lucas Browne. Another good round by Lucas Browne. Barry, what'd you
think? Yeah, I think so. He's fighting an intelligent fight at this stage. James Toney really not getting off with his shot.
Lucas is just not letting him set, not letting him go first, and trying to keep him off balance and unsettling him a little bit.
Yeah, fighting the right fight.
As we listen to the music of Queen. And what an amazing atmosphere here at the Melbourne Exhibitions.
Amazing atmosphere, and to see one of the great all-time greats in action. Although, you know, well past his best, but still seeing slipping, rolling and riding
absolutely.
The punches.
You can see the skill level is still there. Maybe the fitness levels and the body shape is not there, but the skill level is still there. And we've got a long way to go yet. We're into round three of a 12-round vacant world WBF heavyweight championship. An organisation title. I shouldn't call it a world title. It's an organisation title, but it's a title nonetheless. And, of course...
It'll certainly give the winner a leg up in the heavyweights.
There's a thumping jab by James Toney.
And he landed a good overhand right before, too. It hasn't really tried much in the way of
Lucas Browne just starting to... he's complaining about a head clash there, Lucas Browne. But James Toney just...
Tell you what, you wouldn't want that head to hit you, would you?
Not at all. Not at all. And Lucas just started... The left hand starting to drop down a little bit. And there's that little clipping little left hook off the cuff. Gee, that was a good punch. Lucas doesn't want to drop his hands. He doesn't want to get too overconfident here.
Without doubt.
There's a clubbing right hand by Lucas Browne. James Toney's just got that wry smile and says, yeah, okay, that's not too bad, but you got to do better than that. Australia's great white hope, Lucas Big Daddy Browne, former MMA fighter based out of Perth in Western Australia. Take it all before him. He won the Australian heavyweight title from Colin Wilson.
Good jab. Good jab from Lucas that far.
Oh, there was an exchange of right hands. Oh, he's missed again, Lucas. He's just can't find his range. And, of course, the ever evasive James Toney just made that right hand, just went straight over the shoulder, Barry. That's an amazing skill.
Incredible. And good jab from Toney.
He talks to Lucas Browne and says, come on, brother, let's go.
Same way he did when him and Danny Green went to war in the gym.
Absolutely. And I know you're watching tonight, Dan. Wish you and Angelo and all the boys over there all the best in Perth.
For sure. Wish you were here.
Absolutely wish you were here. And you get into the gym and start doing something, Green Machine, because it's not over for you yet, my friend.
Yeah, I don't think Danny's made his mind up yet.
No, I don't think so neither, and arguably he's one of Australia's finest,
and
he really put our sport back on the map. And, you know, whether you love him or whether you hate him, but certainly Anthony Mundine has had a little bit to do with that as well. But Danny Green certainly kept him honest.
Without doubt, Danny's done he had a magnificent career.
And, you know, the best part about Danny Green, outside the boxing ring, nothing changes. He's just genuinely a nice guy, you know, and he's everybody's favourite. We're inside 10 seconds. Lucas Browne misses with this little short right hand.
I think he landed that one, to be honest, but I think...
No, I thought it missed. James just slipped and parried the punch.
How did you see that one?
I thought Lucas Browne won that simply because of his aggression. Nothing more. A couple of the punches, and Barry, I think you went the other way, did you?
Yeah, I think James Toney just about edged it myself. But,
okay.
Not a great deal in it. I think James landed a good right hand. He landed some good jabs. And the thing he's making Lucas miss a great deal.
He has made Lucas miss a lot, absolutely.
Lucas did get through with one good right hand there, I thought.
Yeah, he got one through, but I thought his left hand kept him in the round. You know, that was only from my observation.
Yeah. No, look, his left hand is definitely working well.
And, of course, you know, realistically, Lucas Browne has it all to gain and nothing to lose.
Oh.
You know, realistically, great matchmaking. I have to commend our matchmaker and the people behind the scenes who have done a marvellous job here tonight. But, guys, you've really brought the sport to another level down here in Melbourne. And what a tremendous effort as we come for round number four. The boys, the big boys meet in centre ring. There's that nice lead from James Toney. That was flush. A little bit more urgency in his work now. Misses with the right hand.
Good jab from Lucas there. Lovely jab.
Just slipped and parried that punch again over the top, that right hand. He's a master of that.
And for our viewers out there, when you miss shots, it takes it out of you.
Absolutely it does.
Good jab from Lucas.
Hitting used air. There's no joy in hitting used air, Barry. It drags it out of you.
Does it ever.
And I hope you're enjoying our Epicenter TV coverage of our live stream coming to you in your computers, wherever you are, might be in the world. And I hope all of Australia is watching this. Just loses his balance again.
His balance is not good.
No, well, what happened? He came in. He came in to throw the right hand, and Lucas threw his own right hand. And referee Ignatius Missalides is just going to ask for a towel to wipe a little bit of water from, or maybe a little bit of Vaseline from the centre of the ring there.
Certainly, the canvas has certainly got a grit on it.
It absolutely has. You can see it. There's no, it's not slipping. I think it was just a case of the two bodies coming together and the bulk and the size of two fighters, and here we go, back round number four, live action again.
Have a look how relaxed.
Look at it. We've got, 230 kilos of pure fighting machine in centre ring wanting to hurt each other.
Certainly have.
Okay, and referee Ignatius Missalides just warns him about the use of the head. A little bit of redness coming between the eyebrows of Lucas Browne there.
Lucas's right eye's got a bit of a lump under that right eye.
Lucas getting a little bit of urgency in his work, but James just smiles as he makes him miss. And I guess that was a fairly definitive round for Lucas Browne.
Definitely.
Entertainment here this, the whole afternoon, Barry, has been nothing short of spectacular. There's flames going off. The dancing girls are dancing up a storm here. The ring card girls are absolutely some of the finest I've ever seen.
Yep, certainly great entertainment, Brad. I've got to say my partner, Brian, he's an absolute genius when it comes to putting an event together.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Our judges tonight, Andrew Campbell, Malcolm Booner, and, of course, his lovely wife, Samantha Booner. Our referee in centre ring is Ignatius Missalides. And we're now ready for round number five of this heavyweight collision. Australia's great white hope, Lucas Big Daddy Browne, the Perth-based Australian who's had his last three or four fights over in the UK, had a quick trip up to Brisbane and fought on a Jamie Meyer show up at Richlands and stopped his Japanese at Masataki Takahara over there in one round, and that was just a keep busy fight. And James Toney has had the long haul across from the United States. He's 15 hours alone just to get to Brisbane. Get to Sydney, I should say.
He's been here a week. He's feels as though he's acclimatized well. He's got over the jet lag. But at this stage, Lucas Browne proving too slick.
He's fighting a smart fight, Barry. And, I had a little chat with Mick and Brian earlier on. I've refereed Lucas Browne a couple of times now, and the biggest thing that he's marked that he left on me was that he is an intelligent fighter.
Yep. No, he's an intelligent bloke. There's no doubt about that.
He's walked into a big right hand there. He hit James with the right hand, and James came straight back over the top with him, and that certainly caught his attention. And he knows that his eyes are left hook and a right hand by James. That came out of nowhere. Oh, he's hurt, Lucas, and he's hurt. James is hurt.
Wow.
As he claims, Lucas, I've got a feeling this fight is not going to go the distance.
No, I don't think any way this is going the distance. Both fighters landing big punches.
There's some big bombs being landed there. Who is the most durable? Who's got the most chin? And who wants it most? Who wants the WBF Heavyweight Championship of the World? Australia's great white hope, Lucas Big Daddy Browne? Or the veteran American, the 86-fight veteran American, the future Hall of Fame famer, James Lights Out Toney? In arguably what's the biggest fight and the most competitive fight card of the year here in Melbourne.
James Toney looking for an opening.
Oh, there it is too. Yeah. He brought Lucas in, he got him in, sat him where he wanted to, then hit him with a left hook and a clubbing right hand.
Yep, left
hook. Now, that was really well done, Barry. He didn't have to do too much to bring Lucas in. Lucas actually just fought his fight there.
The left hand landed a couple of times for James Toney this round.
And if, you know, I have a sneaking suspicion, and I know it's not going to happen, but if James Toney at this weight, if he got back down to cruiserweight, wouldn't he make some noise?
Oh, for sure.
You know, like without that excess weight, it's not going to happen. But, you know, wouldn't he really have a say in the cruiserweight division?
He did drop the cruiserweight in one of his recent losses to Dennis Lebedev.
Dennis Lebedev, the Costa Zoo trained Dennis Lebedev.
Took it off 58 pounds and went to Russia and went 12 rounds with Lebedev.
Absolutely, absolutely.
58 pounds, a lot of weight.
And Lebedev is a very good fighter. He's that hard-nosed Russian, real hard hard face. That was a very good round. Actually, that was a good round for James Toney. I thought that round, and, he bridged the gap between him and Lucas Browne in that round.
I think you're
right. I hope you're enjoying our coverage, our live stream, Epicenter TV stream. I think it's epicenter.tv.com. And,
just Epicenter TV.
Epicenter.tv. To the guys who are working behind the scenes, I do apologise, but you're doing a great job. And I hope you're enjoying our coverage of our stream tonight, coming to you from Melbourne. Lucas Big Daddy Browne got it all to gain and nothing to lose as he takes on the veteran American James Toney, hits him with a flush left hand there.
Having a chat to his corner, the great James Toney, the character.
One of the characters of the sport, James Lights Out Toney.
Whinging about a shot round the back there, James Toney. He's probably thrown plenty of them himself.
Originally born in Grand Rapids in Michigan, and now lives in Sherman Oaks in California, a nice part of the world, Sherman Oaks, as he clubs Lucas Browne with that big right hand. Lucas said to himself, oh, gee, what did I do that for? I didn't need to get clubbed by that. Not a bad round for James Toney in that last fight. Lucas worked, made him miss, and he's trying to make him pay now. Ever so conscious of the fact that the short punches of James Toney are dangerous.
They're dangerous. The short punches are dangerous for sure.
Like to see Lucas employ that left jab now. That's just gone away a little bit from his repertoire, like what he had in the early rounds. It won him most of the early rounds.
It was certainly working well for him. But he's tasted the power, I think, of James Toney. A couple of times he was shaken.
Yeah, absolutely he was.
But he's landed some bombs himself. I think he's shaken James Toney.
Oh, there's that little short right out. Oh, that was a slip there. Just actually, James lost his balance. He got hit behind the arm, and he was off balance as he tried to avoid the punch.
Tell you what, you'd think those falls have got to take it out of you too.
Oh, absolutely. You've got to use the energy to get back up.
Yeah. And
113 kilos, you've got to get back up on your feet.
Exactly. Plus, you're hitting the canvas hard.
And, of course, the bulk of these two guys and the size, when you look at Lucas Browne, you know, he's much taller and much bigger, and he's very, very strong, Lucas Browne, in close. And he's not easy to move. And James Toney, I wouldn't imagine, is easy to move. No, it's like two trains hitting together.
It is.
Something has to bounce off of one another.
Certainly.
There's the right hand followed by the uppercut. I see blood on the eyelid of Lucas Browne now. Whoa, the right eye. Is it the right eye of Lucas Browne? There's a clubbing right hand. That certainly caught the attention of Big Daddy. James Toney is not done with yet as Lucas Browne actually slips there. You can see he did slip.
Yeah, you can see that. Shit.
And the referee has now called time out and he's just going to have a wipe of the corner. That's unfortunate.
Come on, Ignatius Jesus.
Fighter safety is paramount.
Safety is paramount, but so is time. I mean, you know, it can't be that
absolutely
wet, surely.
And I just can't see the eye of Lucas Browne. It's on their right eye. There's a little bit of blood, and I'm just concerned that whether that was caused by a punch or whether it was actually caused by a cut. Oh, there's another clubbing right hand followed by the little short left hook by James Toney. And it's a clubbing right hand by Lucas Browne. He goes
James
in. And hurt.
James Toney's hurt.
Oh, he stunned James Toney there.
He was hurt.
He was. Absolutely, he was. This fight has got many twists and turns in it yet, Barry Michael.
It certainly has. The experience of James Toney, the power of Lucas Big Daddy Browne. Lucas looking for that overhand right. James Toney needs a get out of jail punch at the moment, I think. Has he got it in him? The great man, James, lights out Toney.
And there we see
the bell for another round.
The end of round number six. I think that was a good round for Lucas Browne.
Yep. Yeah, he's definitely in front.
He's got a bit of a break now on James Lights Out Toney, Barry. I have him on my unofficial scorecard, 59-55. He's jumped up to a little bit of a break, but look, as you well know, that can be eroded in just one round.
One punch. You know, I think we've seen that James Toney has got the power still.
Oh, absolutely.
And, you know, if he can land a couple of clean shots, I mean, you know, Lucas could be in stride. But Lucas fighting a very smart fight at the moment.
I'm with former world super featherweight champion, the former Commonwealth junior welterweight champion, and dual Australian champion, Barry Michael. And I hope you're enjoying our Epicenter.tv coverage of our live stream coming to you from the Melbourne Convention and Exhibition Centre. And what a remarkable event it has been.
I'm seriously worried about this ring camera. It shouldn't be slipping.
I think there's a little bit of sweat and a little bit of water around on it as well, Barry. That's all I can put it down to. Nothing more. Both boys, it's quite warm here tonight, and both boys are sweating. There's a lot of water in the corner. There's a lot of water on their bodies, and I think that's come down onto that canvas, and it hasn't.
Certainly a lot of sweat.
Absolutely. I hope you're enjoying tonight. How are you seeing this fight at home now? Do you agree with the former world super featherweight champion Barry Michael and myself? I hope so. And we're calling it live for you here at ringside.
James Toney, just his reflexes certainly are.
Oh, clubbing left hook and a nice hard right hand by Lucas Browne as he pushes James Toney away. And referee Ignatius Missalides says, hey, come on, I've warned you, don't push him away. He's made the long trip across the Nullarbor, Lucas Browne. Of course, James Toney's had a long trip across the Atlantic,
across
I think.
The world, yeah, no. And, Lucas fighting a smart fight here. He's still very cagey and dangerous.
There's an exchange of powerful left hands. I should say the Pacific, not the Atlantic, isn't it? Or a hard right hand to the body by James Toney and an equally hard right hand to the side of the head by Lucas Browne.
Good jab from Big Lucas.
There he is. He's got that jab. He seems to have got his range a little bit now. He's growing in confidence each time he hits with that jab. Steps back.
Keeps
takes his
at that
time.
Canvas. There must be some issue there. Which,
absolutely.
You know, it's been specially treated so it doesn't slip. And I'm the promoter, so I'm seriously worried about it.
We might get the boys at Active Labour to have a look at it after this fight's over and done. There's a hard right hand by Lucas Browne. A little left uppercut and a following up right hand by... and that's James Toney with blood coming from the mouth now. Sort of turns around and says, come on, baby. And big thanks to Simmons Homes against tonight, Active Labour, and all the major sponsors and all the crowd that have... the corporate tables and the people who have come to support this magnificent event here tonight. James Lights Out Toney hasn't let anyone down at this stage, and neither has Lucas Browne.
No, he's certainly come to fight James Toney.
I predicted a little earlier on, everyone's going against Lucas. I predicted, there's a big right hand by Toney. That certainly hurt James Browne. But I predicted that I think that the longer the fight goes, I think that, Lucas pulls him over now. That's the third time he's done that. He's just pushed that. That was a blatant push, and I think that...
Lucas bleeding heavily from the left eye.
He is from the left, from the right eye, Barry. And next time he does that, I think that the referee should penalise Lucas, because there's no need to push your opponent, even though he's just maybe coming a little bit frustrated, I think, Lucas Browne, but he doesn't need to be too cute. He's doing very well as he speaks.
He is.
Fighting with care, fighting with...
right eye, heavily bleeding.
And
heavily.
Looks like a couple of cuts here now, Barry.
That's in of round number seven.
As we see the end of round number seven, another good round by Lucas Browne. And he's certainly stolen the break on James Toney now as the Toney corner comes up to referee Ignatius Mussolini's and asks the question and said, hey, listen, how many times are you going to let your fighter push my fighter to the ground?
Yeah.
But come on, you know it's within the rules. We've come all the way out here. We just want a fair shake. And I would say that he's now put himself into a position that if Lucas has to push him over and fouls his opponent again, he has to penalise him.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think you're right, Brad. At least we didn't really have any main issues with the slippery canvas that round, but another great round for Lucas Browne.
Yeah, a good round.
And you know, seriously, James Toney's been hurt on quite a few occasions. Lucas could be. After round four, I thought that Toney was starting to warm up, but Lucas Browne could be the first man to ever stop James Toney.
Absolutely.
The way he's going.
Well, the way it's going, it looks that way, doesn't it, Barry? You know, could see Ricardo Monteleone all the way over from Perth working on the cut of the right eye of Lucas Browne as the boys come out for round number eight. Round eight of a scheduled 12-round championship fight here at the fabulous Melbourne Convention and Exhibition Centre. I just want to say a big thanks to our crew at Paris Productions tonight, as also Pascali and Nick and the boys, Alex. They're doing a great job with the coverage. I hope you're enjoying it on Epicentre TV as well. It's a live stream, and the way to go in watching some of the biggest fights around the world, that you can watch them on your own computer and at a very, very reasonable price. And I take my hats off to yourself, Barry Michael, Brian Armatruder, and of course Mick Gatto, for bringing the fights to the public who can't get here and at a very reasonable price.
Oh, look, you know, thanks to Epicentre TV for that, because, you know, the streaming around the world is gives the average punter a chance at a reasonable price, $15, to watch this great afternoon and evening of boxing.
Beautiful left jab by Big Daddy Lucas Browne. I think, I know it's not too early to say, but James looks like he's lost his way a little bit now, Barry.
Yes,
he's just, he's finding it difficult to get inside the range of Lucas Browne. It's proving a little bit more difficult. As I said, that he just hits him with a little clubbing short left hook.
Nice little left hook.
That, under normal circumstances, probably would have hurt many fighters.
Lucas just shook his head like it wasn't a bother at all.
And I guess the shine has come off both fighters a little bit now. The power has subsided just that little bit. Of course, they're still trying to knock each other over, but it's a real arm wrestle. It's who can land the big one. That's what we're looking for. The game changer, the one punch game changer.
Don't think James Toney's got the reflexes to... He hasn't got the reflexes to put a good combination together, I don't think.
I think he's still capable. If Lucas Browne makes a mistake, James Toney has the ability to make him pay.
Yeah, no, but I think you're right.
I think, now the shine has started to come off him just that little bit, and he's starting to labour a little bit. The mouth is starting to come open a little bit wide. He's standing in front of Lucas, and he doesn't need to do that. He's got a really good jab, and I think there's something in his repertoire. He's got all the punches he needs to start just unloading a little bit. There it is. A two-punch body combination followed up with the left hook.
The old James Toney would have thrown another three or four on top of it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. The master of the body roll, the master of the punch and parry. Has he still got it? I think he still has, but unfortunately tonight he's fighting the fight of Lucas Browne.
Yeah.
But, the funny part is James Toney can fight at this pace all night. 12 rounds, he'll fight at the same pace all night.
Yep. But he's not winning the fight.
He's not
going to win the fight. Yep. And
Lucas is just outworking him at the moment, not doing anything too cute, being very, very careful. He's very, very aware of the power and the hand speed of James Toney. He knows that if he makes a mistake, he can pay for it dearly.
Let's make some noise, Melbourne. Give way to
And there's a huge American contingent that have come out here to that are in the corner of the Toney camp. There's, let me tell you, there's three, there's six in the corner there somewhere. Not all in the corner, of course, but, you know, there's supporters, and there's a number of them up on backstage, I can see. Of course, there's a few here with Kevin Johnson. There's a few here with the other... the Romanian-based American that came out here as
big,
well.
Big entourage.
Oh, absolutely. The logistics of putting this amazing event have been tremendous, and I can't give our promoters and our people behind the scenes enough raps, because it certainly has put boxing on the map here. And boxing's on the map anyway, Barry, as you well know, but all it does is just giving it that nice edge that it's an event. It's a nice event.
It's a and we look event.
As I look around the venue, I see many women, like back in the 70s, Barry, when the women wore ball gowns and they were all dressed up lovely and came to the fights. It was a night out, and we're revisiting that tonight. There's
exactly
a lot of lovely women here dressed to the nines, and it's great to see. They've come to see an American legend in James Toney, and can Australia's great white hope, Lucas Big Daddy Browne, can he bring home the vacant WBF Heavyweight Championship of the world, and in an upset, defeat one of the guys who's arguably one of the hardest fighters in the world to defeat, and that's James Toney.
One of the all-time greats, without doubt, James Toney.
You know, I listen and I have a look at many of the websites, and a lot of the people are saying, oh, you know, Tony's shot, he's this, he's that, and Lucas will win by KO, you know. And I mean, there's a lot of experts that seem to know a lot about the sport that don't even attend some of the fights, Barry, and it's a real shame, because they put a blight on the sport by their inaccurate assessment of what's actually happening in the sport.
I agree with you.
For a few of you experts at home, why don't you get off your backside and come out and pay your money and come to watch some of the fights and see it firsthand, and then you can make a qualified judgment. There's a lovely uppercut by Lucas Big Daddy Browne as he tried. He almost did it there. And there's blood dripping from the right eyelid of Lucas Browne right now.
James Toney needs a knockout here if he's going to have any chance of winning this fight. Lucas Browne.
Oh, there's a powerful straight left. That was a beautiful left lead, Barry, wasn't it?
Yep.
And that's his strong point, Lucas Browne. He's now got into a rhythm. He's got into a pattern now. He's actually worked James Toney out, controlling centre ring, and the blood is just freely dripping down the right eyelid of Lucas Browne. I hope it doesn't impair his vision as he moves around, because James Toney's best punch is arguably his crisp little left hook, and if that blood comes into the right eye, then he's not going to be able to see that little left hook as it comes out. It's a crisp, short, sharp lever. There it was.
I just received a text message from Shane Cameron. He's watching the fight live on Epicenter TV in New Zealand. Shane, cheerio to Shane over there, one of the great Australasian heavyweights. Gave Danny Green a great fight last year. And, you know, scored some massive victories himself. Oh,
great little right hand. Yeah, and the Mountain Warrior, what a tremendous sportsman. He's a credit to New Zealand. I refereed his last fight and he knocked Monty Barrett cold. You know, against all the odds, he picked himself up after the David Tua loss. He came back, he came over here, he beat some of our best. He came back, and of course, Monty Barrett then came out and defeated David Tua. And, you know, the things didn't look good. They thought, well, he looked very good in beating David Tua. Can Shane Cameron beat him? Certainly Shane was up to the task. And Kenny Rainsfield and the team over there, I wish you all the best. I'm glad to see you watching Epicenter TV. There's another great round for Big Daddy Lucas Browne. There we have James Toney. Doesn't look like the James Toney that we know, Barry, as he walked to the wrong corner there.
No, mate. He's, Shane Cameron basically texted me too, that saying that it's a good show, great show, mate, looked terrific, but James Toney's done his dash in the ring, and it's true. We're seeing, the end of a great career, I think.
Oh, absolutely, you know, and look, you know, he was a master. He was magical to watch. He was a pleasant, you know, guy outside the boxing ring, an incredible athlete, and it's not over yet. Look, by no means of a stick, but Lucas Big Daddy Browne is doing the job this afternoon that he has to do. He's just fighting the fight that he has to fight at this particular stage to
without
win the
doubt,
fight.
Without doubt.
As our referee calls us in for the 10th round of this 12 round. And we're in the championship rounds, round 10, 11 and 12, as the boys come to centre ring. The shine has certainly come off both of them, and James Toney looking a little worse for wear. And
I don't think he's got a lot left, James Toney.
No, he hasn't. I guess size, fitness, youth has got a lot to... There's 11 years in youth. There's a lot of height and weight difference, of course.
Yeah, no, I think you could see the way it's going at the moment. I wouldn't be surprised
and,
to see...
And Barry, as you well know, you know, father time beats us all.
Certainly.
You know, the mind says, oh, I can do that. The body says, no, you can't. Yeah, what do you think you're doing, you know? And, as you know, I get in the gym like you and we try and do that. Just as I say that,
James
Toney clubs Lucas Browne with a right hand that certainly caught his attention.
Yeah.
But it's not over until the fat lady sings. Not when you're talking tremendous athletes of the caliber of James Toney and, of course, Lucas Browne.
No, you're right. It's never over. You're always only one punch from disaster. But at the moment, Lucas Browne well in control of this fight. James Toney needs a miracle here. He needs a miracle bomb from maybe 20 years ago. Oh, good right hand from Lucas Browne.
Yeah, he just can't seem to find his range, James Toney. And Lucas is fighting a very, very smart fight, keeping it at range, keeping it, not letting him set, because if he lets him set, he's in trouble. There's sure. That crunching left hand.
Vicious, stiff left jab.
Oh, it's a great left hand.
Lucas Browne.
Denny Green has a beautiful left hand like that. I saw him break the nose of Jason Delia one night when I refereed him over there. And that straight left hand, and I mean, Jason was the absolute warrior. He abused me when I stopped the fight. But Denny hit him with the hardest left hand that I have ever seen in my 40 years in the sport. And he clubs him with a right hand. He's got James in a little bit of trouble there, but Lucas just walks away. He doesn't want to get too cute. He's just doing what he has to do.
Doesn't want to leave himself open for the counter, but he's fighting a very smart fight, Lucas Browne.
Yeah, you know, I said to Mick earlier on that, I the thing that left me with Lucas Browne, the couple of times that I have refereed him, he is a thinker. He is an intelligent fighter. He doesn't want to engage. He doesn't want to sort of say, your turn, my turn, your turn, my turn. Let's see who hits hardest. And he's a thinker and he's a smart boxer. And that's very prevalent tonight because he's winning this fight against an American legend.
Look, James Toney doesn't want to be involved anymore.
No, James is just taking his time, looking for the one shot, trying to... he doesn't want to engage because every time he's come close, Lucas has actually hurt him with that. There's that left hand again as blood splurts from the mouth of James Toney. There's the evasive skills are still there, though, aren't they?
Yeah, but the reflexes aren't.
Yeah, and it's a sad end to an American legend. And Lucas hasn't put the pedal to the metal yet. He's just winning the fight. There's that lovely left hand, fighting smarter, not harder. There's a look of disbelief on the face of James Toney as we see the end of the 10th round, and both fighters just give each other a little wry smile, more of a smile of respect. I've hit you with everything and you're still here.
Yeah, no, James Toney, this has to be the last fight of his career.
You'd like to think so, and the skill level is diminished, you know.
The reflex.
Yeah, absolutely. And of course, Barry, if your reflexes are still there and your ability to see punches coming and not get hit, then, you know, I mean, there's no reason why you can't fight till you're all ages, you know.
True.
There's a number of heavyweight fighters that have proven that, haven't they?
Heavyweights, and look at Bernard Hopkins at 40.
Oh, absolute icon.
Unbelievable.
An icon.
George Foreman at 45.
Yeah, they've proved it all. Yep.
You know, Archie Moore at 55, still one of his last fights, fought the great Muhammad Ali at 55.
Absolutely.
Roberto Duran was still fighting when he was 50 and had a car accident and had to retire.
Yep. Amazing.
Round 11. Is James Toney going to make the distance? He needs a miracle here, I think.
And I think Lucas Browne now knows he's on the balls of his feet now. He knows he's inside. He can see the finish line. He doesn't need to be too cute. He doesn't need to do anything too smart. He's just got to stay on top now. Just keep the left jab in the face of James Toney. Don't let him set. Don't let him do anything too cute. And just stay out of trouble and coast his way home to a points decision tonight.
For sure. The jab's been a winner all night for Big Lucas. He's boxed a very, very intelligent fight indeed.
Against the odds, you know, not too many people gave him much of a chance tonight, Barry. I picked him. I said earlier on, I think he can win on points.
He was actually favourite in the betting.
Yes.
But I figured, to be honest, it was a dangerous, dangerous task to take on a man of, the calibre of James
Toney.
With the relative inexperience of Lucas. But, you know, to his credit, he's... shit.
Yeah, now he
sugar.
Did slip there, absolutely, yes.
Excuse me, Mike, for the viewers. Sometimes forget that I'm on air here. But, yeah, Vera, that was slippery.
It was. And, of course, look, you know what? There's a lot of blood from the eye and the mouth of James Toney. And, of course, there's a lot of sweat. That's really what it is. I don't think that is that slippery. And I think that the boots that Lucas has got have got a rubber sole. I know he's worn those boots for a long, long time now. And maybe they're just starting to wear. They've just started to, you know, to shine up on the bottom.
Yeah, possibly.
You know, and
it's not like
and
the old resin boots, which you can scrape the bottom
not
of.
Not at all.
And,
I guess there's a real cause to bring... To bring pigskin soles back and resin, you know, the resin tray in the corner, like we used to at TV ringside.
Sure, put the resin down.
It was part of the part of the tradition.
It certainly was back in the old days. Good palm there from James Toney. He needs a miracle here.
There's that crunching left lead by Lucas Browne. Coasting Lucas Browne, just doing what he has to do. He's working smarter, not harder. The left lead is continually in the face of James Toney, as you can see with the mouth open, the blood coming out of the mouth. That's a response of the lead of Lucas Browne.
Way in front on points.
And Ricardo Monteleone has done a very, very good job on the right eye of Lucas Browne. Great corner work over there to the Lucas Browne team.
James Toney should not.
Oh, nice little left hook, and another equally as good a left hook by James Toney. But there's the straight lead, and he shouldn't get hit with that sort of stuff, Barry.
Straight in the mouth. Yeah. Look at the mouth. The mouth covered in blood.
Once upon a time, you would never have got hit with that punch.
No.
Are we seeing history in the making? Are we seeing the legendary James Toney, a future Hall of Famer? The
last
veteran,
fight.
The 86 or now 87 fight veteran. Is this his last fight? You might be witnessing a little bit of history here. I hope for his sake he's got a family, he's got all his children's name on the front of his trunks there, and there looks like there's Prince, James Jr., Brittany, Tiffany, Morgan and Jasmine, and they can be well proud of their father. He's got nothing left to prove in this business. Whether he never has another fight, he will always remain a legend in my eye and the eye of you. And another very good round for Lucas Browne. On my unofficial card, Barry, I have it 109 to 100.
Yeah, no, fair call, Brad. It's definitely one-sided. Can James Toney see the last round out?
Well, I think, I think he can, because I'll tell you why. If I was in the corner of Lucas Browne, I would be saying, yeah, listen, don't get too cute. I don't want you to do anything out of the ordinary. Come on home. Just bring it home. Just do what you have to do. Don't get hit. Don't get tagged. Just come home and, you know, you've got the points win. And in doing so, you beat a master. You beat a legend. And that's all you have to do. You don't have to try and bowl him over and get him out of there.
No, because he's still dangerous with one punch. But
absolutely.
I mean, you know, it would be an amazing thing on the resume of Lucas Browne to be the only man to stop him.
Absolutely, absolutely. But let me tell you this, Barry. It's not going to sound silly, but do you know what? James Toney, I think, can stop Lucas Browne, but I don't think Lucas Browne can stop James Toney.
Do you really? Yeah, look.
And the boys touch gloves. Not at this late stage of the fight now. I think Lucas has got it all to gain and nothing to lose. He's running on adrenaline now. He knows he's done a very, very good job. The urgency will come out in James Toney. He's going to try and pull it out of the fighter here somewhere along the line.
I think he'll try, but I don't think he's capable.
He doesn't want to leave it in the ring. He doesn't want to leave Australia. He's had a great time out here. He didn't come out for a holiday. He's actually come out to fight. And I know he had plans to come out here again. And let's hope that he comes out of this very, very well. It's been a night of mixed fortunes here tonight. Sad ending to the OPBF heavyweight title. Solomon Hamono lost his OPBF heavyweight title to... the brilliant American Kevin Johnson.
Absolutely brilliant as far as his player boxing.
And Lucas, Big Daddy Browne, Australia's great white hope. Looks like he's on his way to victory, but we've still got probably another 2 minutes to go yet before we start counting the chickens.
Yep, you never know in boxing.
Now the hands are up of Big Daddy. He's not going to be too cute. He's not going to be too smart. He knows he's just got to play it smarter, not harder. There's a nice lead again. That's a beautiful left lead, keeping James Toney off balance. Beautiful thumping left lead.
James Toney calls him on. It's a bit sad, actually. You know, James Toney must know that he's virtually lost every round.
Absolutely. I think, Barry, we've given James maybe two rounds, I think. Yep, maybe one round. I think he's I've given him one round on my unofficial scorecard.
Yep. Oh,
there's a clubbing right hand. And that certainly caught James. James, that wry smile, but he knows, hey, he just wants to survive now. He doesn't want to end up on the seat of his pants again.
Look at the blood, the side of
it's
James
just coming out of the mouth.
Very, very swollen. Yep.
Let's make some noise, Melbourne, Australia, finals!
And you know, Barry, let me tell you this. Lucas Browne is one of the real nice guys in Australian boxing.
He's a lovely
gentleman. And look, I know this is going to sound silly coming from a competitive sportsman like Lucas
Browne. He's got James Toney in trouble.
He's in a bit of strife here.
Can he stop him? He's got him in trouble. He's backed off.
Yep, he's backed off. And you know what?
Out of respect, you think he's done that.
I believe that Lucas Browne doesn't really want to put a damaging end to the career of James Toney.
No,
out of respect. Just out of respect. I think he knows he's a legend. He's beaten a legend.
I think Lucas can finish him now.
Yeah, I think if he really put the foot down, he might be able to get him out of there. But you know what? The nice guy that he is, he doesn't want to embarrass a future Hall of Famer.
He just wants
to win the fight. He wants to do the very best he can. And he's done that. And he's done it in an inimitable style
as
well.
We're inside 10 seconds.
There's not going to be any knockout now. But Lucas Browne, you can hold your head up high, young man.
For sure.
33-year-old Australian, the great white hope. He's brought it home and he knows he's done something special. As lights out James Toney and as they embrace in centre ring. And James comes back to his trainer and there's a look. He knows he's got a bad cut on the inside of his mouth. And what a tremendous end to tonight's program here at the Melbourne Exhibition and Convention Centre as my co-commentator and co-promoter Barry Michael makes his way up in the centre ring and with promoter Mick Gatto and of course James's wife has come into the ring there to console at this stage the unofficial result and take nothing away from James Toney. He came to fight. He ran into a committed, dedicated, hard at the ball Lucas Browne tonight. And I think he did a marvellous job. And Lucas, Big Daddy Browne, you can hold your head up high because tonight you have done something that not too many other fighters in the history of the sport have done. For the record, those of you at home, I had it, my unofficial scorecard, 119 to 109 in favour of the great white hope, Australia's Lucas Browne. And let's see the official scorecards as we get up here tonight from our ring announcer, John Demacoli. The ring is full of people at the moment and what an amazing atmosphere here tonight at the Melbourne Exhibition and Convention Centre. James lights out Toney, came to spoil the party of Lucas Big Daddy Browne. And unfortunately, I think he has pulled up short tonight. But look, take nothing away from him. I heard someone say, to beat a legend, you become a legend. And I don't think anyone would deny Lucas Browne his win tonight. It was a marvellous performance. He fought smarter. He kept that left jab. He found his range. He got tagged a little bit earlier on in the fight. He was very, very careful of his fight. And Lucas Browne, you've done Australia proud, my friend, as he comes over and shakes hands. And to Ricardo Monteleone, done a tremendous job in the corner with the eye tonight. Team Lucas Browne from Perth in Western Australia. Sam Greco, the great Kyokushin martial artist has come up to see Lucas Browne as well. And, of course, our co-promoter, Mick Gatto. And let's go up to centre ring to hear the official announcement from our ring announcer, Mr. John Demacoli. As the boys embrace in centre ring, great sportsmanship. And referee Ignatius Missalidis did a great job, a tremendous referee, really coming part of some of Australia's boxing officialdom. Let's hear the official scores.
To the judges' scorecards. Your judge, Andrew Campbell, scored the contest 117-111. Samantha Borner score the contest 119-109. Malcolm Borner score the contest 120-108. Your winner and new World Boxing Foundation heavyweight champion of the world, Luca! Luca!
And there it is, the official announcement. Lucas Big Daddy Browne has captured the vacant WBF World Heavyweight Championship with a unanimous points decision over the veteran American James Lights Out Toney, with scores from Judge Andrew Campbell 117-111, Samantha Borner, she got it right, Samantha Borner 119-109, and of course her husband Malcolm Borner 120-108. He hasn't given Lucas Browne a round. My unofficial scorecards, as I said on earlier on, was 119-109. Tremendous result here in Australia. A tremendous result for Australian boxing. Lucas, Big Daddy Browne has really made a statement here. Let's go and have a quick listen to what he's got to say.
Lucas, you're certainly a fighter on the up here in Australia. You're now taking your record of 16 fights with 16 wins. You've only gone the distance twice. Twice you've gone the distance. You've won unanimous points decision. All your other fights have been finished very, very early. So you can go both ends of the spectrum. Quick knockouts, 12 round fights. Well done. What was your plan going into the night, knowing who you're up against? And did that plan unfold well in your brain?
Thank you very much, and thank you very much, Senator. All the fans in mind. Yeah, the plan was, obviously, I'm just going to avoid my right, which is what I've been working with. I've been working on the left, but on the slippery floor and everything else, I didn't quite plan for the left that I wanted to, so I just stuck to the jab. Which is pretty much what happened the last time I went the distance. I just stuck to the jab out and run it that way. So, yeah, we worked with Ricardo, one more round yet. I'm just very happy with everything is. Obviously, I'm still...
Enough up 12 rounds. I just didn't like the floor, it was very slippery. But otherwise, thank you to an absolute legend in James Toney. I couldn't be happier, thank you.
Now, as stated earlier by Mick Dad on the boys, the winner of the last fight, the semi main event, Kevin Johnson, they announced that that fight may happen. Now you can start looking at another fight. Kevin Johnson could be the next opponent, who's actually stepped in right behind you. The fight will happen. So we're going to see next time round.
The fight's going to happen. I think everybody out here want to see this fight happen. Am I right? Am I right? I think we're going to build. I like it. I loved it. I lived up to my end of the deal. Like I said, they gave me a contract tonight. I signed. We'll definitely be back in 90 days. Block ass, kick ass, do what we do, how we do what we do. Right here in the same ring. Let's clean up the blood a little bit. Once the fall, but we'll be good. But I'm here. 90 days. 120. We're in the building. Definitely. Plan to see you. Definitely. Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've got a quick word. Lucas, you want to finish up by thanking some people before we close up the show?
Basically, yeah, quick thank you to all the sponsors. We've got Fight Labs, Kings of Ink, Muscle Mass Therapy. We've got my manager, Matt, trainer Ricardo sitting next to me, my mate Andrew, obviously family, friends, fans, everyone, yeah, my kids at home who might be watching it, if not, they'll be watching it soon. Yeah, there's much more to come for me, and this is just the beginning.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for your new World Boxing Foundation Heavyweight Champion of the World, Lucas Big